Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. Today in this tutorial, we are going to learn about the grid system used in UI semantic. So the grid is a structure which is used to align negative spaces in our structure. Using a grid makes content appear to flow more naturally on our page. The grids divide horizontal space into indivisible units called the columns. Semantic's default theme uses 16 columns, so instead of 12 columns as been seen in Bootstrap 4, the UI semantic, it practically uses 16 columns per row into a definite defined grid. If we head back to our text editor, this is the project so far that we had created, and we had practically used a container class in our last tutorial, and this was the result as we can see. Now today we are going to choose a step further. We are going to use all the grid along with all the rows and columns into it. So in the first place, let's create another container class in the next case we will be creating an UI grid. Here it goes. Now this is the declaration where you need to declare the abbreviation of UI right over here, as we had done in case of declaring the container. Now here the row element, and then we need to define the column element. So unless Bootstrap, where we had used this dot call right over here, we will be using the full version of it, which is known as column. Now, in the next case, we will be creating a button class of here. So we have created this UI fluid button. This is another UI semantic element. This is the class name which has been used to create a button. Now all we are going to do, we will be copying this thing 16 times, and we will be changing the name. So we have created all those elements into this UI container. Inside it, we have created a grid element. We have used this grid structure, and we have created another row. And inside this row, we have created each and every of these single grids. Now let's press Ctrl S and head back to our project terminal, and we can see that this will be the result. We can see that each of these button elements, those are practically present into our UI semantic container. Now, if we just head back to our text editor first, and if we create another button element like this one, this is the 27 here, press Ctrl S, and now if we reload, we can see that the last button element, it is practically descending down out of this individual row. So the point is, in a single row inside a particular grid, it will be holding 16 grids in case of UI semantic. This is the first thing that we need to understand. And that is why this last button element, it practically descends down, it practically gets down off the way, forming into a new row right over here. As an example, if we talk about a simple table element, what had we done? In the first case, we had created a table element, then we had created, let me do this thing after you so that we can see it better. So in the first case, all we did, we created a table in the first place. Then the next thing that we did, we created a row, and in the next case we created a column. So what is the point? The point is we are practically using a similar tabular structure right over here, and that is why we need to wrap up elements into a definite row. And this is exactly why we are using this individual column elements inside a definite row, which is in turn appearing inside a definite grid class. So this is the structure that we need to mention every time. Here goes the first case. Now, for the time being, we will be using this observer class here that we had created earlier. So custom style CSS, we can see that this is the observer class that we had created in the earlier case. If we now head back to our project and reload, we can see that this will be the result. We are using this definite observer class. So if we now inspect our element, we can see here the observer class is being used. So both of them are practically been fused into a single place. Now in the next case, we will be using this grid observer cells or any one of it. So for the time being, we'll be using this grid observer cells class, Control C, along with this grid element. Now reload, and we can see that this will be the result. Let's discard this 17th button element. Over here, we do not have a need of it. We can see it now clearly that this 17th button that we had created earlier is practically beyond the scope of this individual row. Now reload, so the button is now discarded. Let's have a look of this custom style CSS. We had provided a height right over here, so we do not wish to provide any height element for the time being. Press Ctrl S, reload, and this will be the result. Now let's observe the difference between this first container that we are using, and this is the second container that we had created in this purpose, where we are using all the necessary elements which is required in forming up the structure. So we had used a grid element right over here along with this container. We had used the row, we had used the column, and we can see that clearly there is a slight width mismatch or difference between the first container and the second container.